Mr. Yoho.
The gentleman is recognized.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to thank Chairman McCall, Mr. Phillips, for your leadership on this, and Mr. McGovern. You have been a strong leader in this, and I appreciate it. And this is the way Congress should work. We come together on a common goal, we get things passed, and it makes a significant difference. I rise today in support of H.R. 4331, the Tibetan Policy and Support Act of 2019. I want to thank Representative McGovern for his work on this important and timely legislation, which would reauthorize the Tibetan Policy Act of 2002 and reaffirm our commitment to the Tibetan people. Since the 1950 invasion of the Chinese PLA forces, Tibet has been a land of occupation and oppression. For too long, the Chinese government has utilized campaigns of aggression and intimidation in trying to silence and bully its neighbor and territories. In that regard, the people of Tibet have not been spared. The number of displaced Tibetans number in the hundreds of thousands, with 110,000 taking refuge just in India alone. I join my colleagues in Congress in reiterating our support for Tibet, the Tibetan people, and the protection of their distinct cultural identity. I also believe that as one of Tibet's strongest partners, the U.S. Congress should hear from Tibet's political and spiritual leaders, which is why I introduced legislation last year to invite the Dalai Lama to address a joint meeting of Congress via teleconference to discuss the peaceful solutions to international conflicts. Madam Speaker, this legislation has wide bipartisan support in the House, and to the people of Tibet, know that we support your fight against adversity and for religious freedom. This legislation makes it clear that the U.S. Congress will not sit on the sidelines and watch as a spectator, but rather advocate strongly for increased protections for the Tibetan people. And I reserve.